Writing code has always been my happy place. That would explain why the last 25 years of my life has been spent writing a lot of code, I guess. But writing unit tests for that code has always been less fun for me. When I heard that Claude 3.7 was pretty fantastic at coding, I wanted to experiment with generating unit tests for my code. So over the last few weeks, I've spent some time experimenting with Claude and had some pretty successful results, as well as some failures. So in this video, I'd like to share 5 insights into how Claude has helped me improve my unit testing productivity. Lesson 1. Create a system prompt. So when I first approached this problem, my expectation was that I'd have to primarily deal with hallucination, as in Claude would be producing tests that just don't make sense for the code that's provided. And for sure that's happened a little bit, but actually the most practical problem I've had is the volume of tests that Claude has produced. As in, I can't quality assure the volume of code that Claude has generated in one go. It was just too much for me. You can think of a system prompt as a way of giving a large language model initial context and instructions on how to respond when you pass new prompts to it. The content of that system prompt is entirely up to you. In the description below, I've linked to the system prompt that I use. That's primarily doing 3 things. First of all, it uses the persona pattern to tell the language model to respond as an expert software tester, specializing in 2 things: defensive programming and unit testing using Pytest. The second thing is the language model will analyze any code before it generates tests. And the third thing is that I can control what type of test it will produce. And I've split that into 3 types of tests. So I'm going to access Claude through perplexity.ai's pro service. So I can click here and choose Claude 3.7, or if I wanted to, I could use the reasoning version of the model. I just paste in my system prompt. So you can see that what Claude has responded with is a confirmation that it has understood my system prompt. Lesson 2. Ask Claude to analyze your code before generating tests. My system prompt includes a command to analyze the functionality of any code provided and suggest defensive program improvements, for example, improvements in input data validation. This is to generate more context for Claude before any type of tests are generated. And I found this is definitely a useful method for improving the quality of the tests that Claude generates. I've provided some example code that you could try with Claude yourself if you choose. I'll link to that in the description below. It's stored in the metrics module. There's 3 functions within that. There's the mean absolute error function. That itself calls a validate inputs function. The validate inputs function is there to check the contents of the parameters passed into that function. It's going to call 2 other functions, convert to array and validate single array. There's nothing of an immediate concern in the defensive programming suggestions, but they are sensible overall. So for example, I've hard coded some values and it's suggesting a final safeguard check on the return values from mean absolute error. I'm not convinced that's fully needed, as the validate inputs function will raise errors if there's an issue beforehand. Lesson 3, provide your own test data, particularly if you're asking Claude to do quantitative calculations. The first type of tests I'm going to ask Claude to generate are going to be related to the mean absolute error function only. We're going to focus on core functionality tests, and we're going to restrict the unit tests that Claude generates to calculations that I've provided. So let's take a look at what tests Claude has generated. So the first thing to say, as it's adhered to my instructions and used Pytest, it's also imported my implementation of mean absolute error from my metrics module. It's using the Pytest parameterize decorator. That seems sensible, and it's included within there my examples. So we're testing the absolute error functionality, Python lists. Lesson 4, remember the basics of testing. Claude is pretty good at giving you a broad range of tests. However, I recommend splitting up your tests into those that check core functionality, edge cases, and dirty tests where we check the code fails as expected with certain values. That's just simple good practice when you're testing any code. So I asked Claude to generate some dirty tests for the validate single array function, and I allowed Claude to generate its own test data for these. Let's have a quick look through. So we're testing empty arrays, not a number, infinity. So we can see here we're mixing infinity and normal values. We're testing a Boolean array. And we've got our first mistake with Claude here. So it's mixing Boolean values with integer values. So what NumPy will do is convert that to a zero before it is passed into validate single array. And so no value error will be raised. So that's a mistake. And then we've got the same mistake here with text mixed array with Boolean, where we're mixing Boolean and integer values, because there's no way for validate single array function to know this is what was specified originally by the user. You can see here that I've just copy pasted those new dirty tests into my test metrics module. Let's now run those with Pytest and see if the two tests we expect to fail do fail. Yes, that looks like it's failed as expected. We can see we've got two fails there. The first is in the test Boolean array, and then the second is the test mixed array with Boolean, where we did effectively the same test. So as these are not valid tests, the solution to this is to remove them from our test suite. Lesson 5, quality assurance still matters. So while there is still no free lunch in data science, I do think with Claude and unit testing, there is a discount on offer that you should take advantage of. We've already seen Claude make a couple of mistakes. I think that's very forgivable because it still greatly increases my productivity in terms of writing these tests. However, I think there's a few other things we can think about to try and improve our quality assurance of the unit tests that Claude is providing. For example, as well as the code, we can ask Claude to provide a summary of the generated tests. That's going to help us sort through things a lot quicker without having to read all of the code. The other thing I like to do is provide some guidance in the system prompt about some of the Pytest functionality I would like Claude to make use of. One of the issues I found was that it was not making use of the most efficient ways of generating Pytest tests. For example, it wasn't using the parameterize function, or it failed to use the Pytest approx function. The other thing I found was how you specify your test data that you pass to Claude may matter. So as an example, in my mean absolute error calculations, I first specified the y_true and y_pred data inside square brackets. It turns out that Claude interpreted that as those should always be Python lists. So all the tests that were generated were with Python lists, and we ignored the other array-like structures such as pandas data frames or NumPy arrays. It was only by quality assuring the functions that had been generated that I was able to pick up that omission. As always, I'll make the code and the prompts that I used in the video available on GitHub. I'll link to that in the description below. And if you've listened to the video for this long, thanks very much. Perhaps you could consider subscribing to the channel and smashing that like button. But perhaps you need to learn more about how prompting large language models actually works. If that's the case, check out this video on the screen now.